On the eve of Labor Day, President Benigno Aquino held a dialogue with labor leaders to listen to their concerns. A dialogue in which the president expressed his commitment to protect their welfare and recognize their contributions to the growth of the economy. And joining us tonight on News Live is Labor Secretary Rosalinda Baldos, who was with the president this morning for the dialogue. Ma'am, welcome to News Live. Ma'am, good evening.
Hi, good evening, Robert.
Ma'am, how was the dialogue of the president with the labor leaders this morning?
The dialogue went very well. It was a very candid talk that the president had right after the formal ceremony. And what the president told them is that I consider your demands very reasonable. That's why I am bringing with me the cabinet secretaries who can come out with some details, including various options on how to be able to meet some of the demands. But he also told them that there are demands, especially in the area of taxation, where legislation would be required. And he already instructed that a draft bill should already be prepared by the Department of Finance so that the structural issue could be addressed through the legislative measure.
Ma'am, a number of concerns were raised. Can I just mention it one by one for you to actually answer and how the president addressed it? Let's start with a proposal to certify the security of tenure bill for Congress to consider.
This is something to do with the issue of contractualization. The president addressed this issue at least in two ways. One is to ask the Tripartite National Peace Council to take another second look at the bill, so that it could be deliberated upon within the context of the entire Book 5 of the Labor undergoing review in the Tripartite National Peace Council. And he said that while this bill would be addressing the needs or would add benefits to wage and salaried workers, the impact of the bill on the self-employed and also on the unpaid family workers, which is around 10 million as against 1.8 million wage and salaried workers, should be considered in the deliberation. So he said that the request for having the bill certified should still be subject to further study.
Ma'am, how about the call to improve the efficiency of the implementation of our labor laws, commonly referred to as 555, or the abusive practice of renewing contracts every 5 months?
Yeah, that was addressed squarely by the president. As a matter of fact, last year during Labor Day, he already created 372 plantilla items at the Department of Labor and for labor compliance officer, the first in the history of the Labor Department where we were given that much amount of new plantilla position, and we were told that throughout the world we are only three countries who have given much support to labor compliance or labor standard enforcement. And so what we did is coordinate with the DBM on this, and last February 8th we were given the approved plantilla position and the budget. We're now in the process of appointing the 372. We committed to the president that by June, every position will be filled up. They will undergo a three-month training, and then afterwards, they will be filled in all the 67,000 establishments throughout the country so that we can comply with the instruction of the president that at least in a year, all the inspectionable establishments should be visited by this labor compliance officer. Right now, we visit around 24,000 with the existing plantilla personnel that we have.
Ma'am, will this be implemented for both the private and government sector?
This is for the private sector. The concerns on terms and conditions of employment for the public sector is for the civil service to handle.
Okay. Ma'am, with regards to the issue of tax exemptions, is the president open to this?
The tax exemption for minimum wage earner is something that should be studied in terms of the possible amendment to the existing tax law, because what the workers would like is the existing minimum wage tax exemption, especially if there is an addition of just a few pesos or a few what we call de minimis, some benefits that would exceed the minimum wage that they are receiving, they will be taxed. And sometimes they will be a part of what they are already enjoying. So the request that there should be a range of the existing 30,000 pesos that would still be exempted over and above the minimum wage should be added or increased to 60,000. Those issues will be altogether studied in the existing possible amendments to the tax structure. But what the President instructed the Cabinet Secretaries, especially the Cabinet Secretaries in the economic cluster, is to find out other options where minimum wage earner can still be assisted na, since the law will take a while to be filed and to be passed in Congress. In the meantime, what the President is saying is there could be some allocated amount where certain benefits will be used to augment the income of minimum wage earner. And they were given until May 30 to prepare for this, meaning the labor leaders that this is the President dialogue with is, you study what are the priorities of the minimum wage earner that could be addressed not in the form of the tax demand that you are saying. And by May 30, you should be able to present that already to the cabinet secretaries.
Now, ma'am, looking at job mismatch, this is also a concern of employers since many applying for their jobs don't really have the skills to qualify for these jobs. Is this being addressed by the Education Department and TESDA? And what is the role of the Department of Labor in helping minimize this?
Of course, the role of the Department of Labor is to see to it that we send the labor market signals in a very timely and very accurate way. What are the jobs in demand? In where industries these jobs are? Which regions they are? So these are all sourced and accessible through our field job net. And then after that, we also send signal to the Education Department that these are the courses that would be advised students to take. And then any gaps, just in case you are already applying for a job and the only reason why you cannot be accepted is you lack a certain training to make you qualified, then testing through the training scholarship free.
The President spoke of employees' compensation benefits for both government and the private sector groups. Was the disparity raised and addressed by the President's executive order?
This, we find out in the Employees' Compensation Commission that the benefits when you suffer some injury, sickness, or while working, these are all work-related workmen's compensation claim, the benefits that are being enjoyed by the private sector is higher than that of the government sector. So what the President did through the executive order is to equalize the benefits that will be given also with the public sector.
Now, ma'am, looking at the SSS pension scheme, why is there a need to amend this?
The pension scheme is under review because there seems to be a huge unfunded liability of SSS. So while looking at the demands of the labor where they are asking for some adjustment in the benefits, SSS benefits, the President has to bring to their attention the other side of the problem, which is the need to also increase the contribution of the employers and the workers because these are contributory in equal shares to be able to address whatever are their demands. So the SSS now is studying these two reforms, the reforms on increasing the SSS benefits and the reforms on increasing the SSS premium.
And finally, ma'am, the President said Labor Day should be a day of celebration and be called Good Jobs Day. How did the labor leaders respond to this call?
Well, I think they share the concern of the President that we still have a huge unemployment and underemployment. We still have 2.9 million unemployed and also 7 million underemployed. And that's why they want to be part of the agro-industrial plan deliberation because they want to see to it that the policies are more on employment focus so that our growth would be accompanied. So this said so many good this growth in the economy into growth in jobs, and I think they welcome that kind of suggestion from the president. But of course, traditionally they will still not give up their own way of celebrating it, which is joining rallies. This is that they can use. What is it that one say? Addressment. So it might take a they can strictly truly the jobs fair that we are having, mm-hmm. 74 of which nationwide. Of course, we had this one in Tarlac with a very big percentage, 32% are already hired on this path. So this that was a good start, and hopefully the 74 jobs fair will also result in a bigger percentage of hired on this path and near hires where we could still follow it up with the company for the next 1 or 2 months if they submit themselves to interview, if they submit themselves to training, and so that the hiring could be more this year than last year.
Okay, on that note, thank you very much for joining us tonight here at News Live. That was Labor Secretary Rosalinda Baldoz. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.